My name is Monique Hedmann. I work at the Neurological Institute at Columbia University. I'm currently a public health researcher, but I'm also a pre-medical student who's applying to medical school this year. And I'm very interested in addressing stroke and Alzheimer's disease. I was born in Houston, Texas, but I was raised in Los Angeles, California. Particularly living in Los Angeles and Atlanta allowed me to see how poor health can really impact underserved communities. And it really inspired me to want to do something about it. My grandmother had a stroke when she was in her 40s, and the entire time that I knew my grandmother before she passed away, she lived in a nursing home, and she couldn't speak very well, she couldn't move very well, so I was personally affected by that. Dr. Noble and I have developed a novel elementary school-based education program teaching children about Alzheimer's disease, empowering them to get their loved one to a doctor if they recognize the symptoms and to teach their family members how to recognize early symptoms of Alzheimer's.
Upon a time in a city called Harlem, there was a young kid who had a big problem. Every time he came from school, he would observe the things his father would do. That wasn't so.
Gotta keep your brain healthy every day to stay ahead of the game. You gotta eat right to run and play.
Now let me tell you something. Stop smoking and drinking and start thinking about the kind of food he was eating, and it changed his life forever. And him and his son sometimes exercise together. Sometimes kids see what you can't see. Sometimes kids see what you can't see. Sometimes kids see what you can't see. And in this story, the kid was me.
And so it's being involved in research personally for me has been very fulfilling, because I've been able to address some of these diseases that have affected me and my family members personally. Both of my parents are physicians, and so I've grown up understanding the importance of research and the science behind all of the good work that we do in health. I witnessed surgeries as a teenager. That was really my first encounter with science. And then I got really interested in programming from a public health perspective. But it was really as a public health student that I understood how important research is, because, you know, it's great to want to do something, but you really have to have research to back its effectiveness. Research is really a matter of life and death in both public health and medicine. We're all aging all the time. And we need a lot of people who are interested in doing research in aging. And we also need people who are interested in developing successful and impactful programs. But I'm also interested in doing research in infectious disease. I recently took a class on virology and learned about how research has helped us to develop vaccines. And I would like to contribute to that field as well as a physician. You know, you put so much effort and you put so many resources into developing an intervention. It's important that you have the research to back it up, so that if you're gonna move forward with that amount of effort, you know that your intervention has a good chance of succeeding. We all learn about how to be adults. You know, we learn from our mistakes. Everything is trial and error, and so research is basically trial and error, but the information that you get from research can change the world and can really change the environment around them. It can really affect people in a positive way. And so I would just tell young people that going into research is a real surefire way of making an impact in the world, and that doesn't even just pertain to, you know, their immediate surroundings or their city. That pertains to the country and the rest of the world. And they can touch people in other countries just from their work that they could do here. And it has tremendous implications. So I would say there's real power in research, and they should try to harness it.